Why don't we watch another patient scenario?
Louise Wood?
Yes.
Hi, come on in, Louise. Doing okay there? Do you have a seat? My name's Paula. I'm going to ask you a couple questions about what brought you in here today and get your blood pressure, okay?
Okay. I feel really silly being here, but the girls where I work insisted that I come over and get checked out.
So what's going on?
I have this pain. It's like a constant pressure. It's not like my heartburn. This makes me sick to my stomach.
How long has this been going on?
About 3 hours.
Okay. Have you taken anything for it?
One of my coworkers gave me an antacid. It didn't do anything. I'm just so tired.
Okay. I'm going to get your blood pressure and ask you a couple more questions. How old are you?
57.
Okay, and on a scale of 0 to 10, with 10 being the worst pain that you can imagine, how would you rate that pain right now?
About a 7.
Okay, and
Nurse, this isn't going to take long, is it? Because I've got to get back to work. I've got so much work to do.
You know, I can't tell you exactly how long it's going to take, but it is really important that you see the doctor today.
Okay.
Okay. Do you have any medical problems?
I have high cholesterol, and I've had some heartburn lately.
Okay. Do you take any medicines every day on a regular basis?
Yes. It's here in my purse.
Okay. Can I see? Great. Thanks.
This 57-year-old female presents to the emergency department with epigastric area pressure. She has a history of high cholesterol and seems to be stressed about work, all risk factors for cardiac disease. We know from the research that women with heart disease do not present with the classic signs of chest pain and shortness of breath. Usually, their discomfort is more upper GI, and many will complain of being tired. This patient is currently stable and does not require immediate life-saving interventions. But she is high risk for cardiac disease. She meets the criteria for ESI level 2. If her blood pressure was low or her heart rate was high, low, or irregular, and her skin was cool and diaphoretic, she would then be in ESI level 1. This patient is currently ESI level 2. Interesting woman. What do you think? Do you agree with that?
Yes, that really makes sense.
Mm-hmm. Women are different, aren't they?
Yes. One of the first things I noticed about her is that she was very short of breath, and that kind of alarmed me. Said the whole time that she was talking to you, that was what I was thinking about. Okay, that she's short of breath, you know, I need to try to help.
You needed to do something
yes,
to intervene.
Soon.
Even if she was just being dramatic,
right.
You know, which, you know, obviously in an emergency department we have patients who present that way. But would that change your priority rating at all? Would you still make her a 2?
I would, and I was considering the question of whether she was hysterical and nervous or whether mm-hmm. she was actually short of breath.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing is that she did take an antacid and it mm-hmm. didn't help at all, which is leans me still in the direction, further in the direction of a possible
right.
cardiac condition.
Right.
That's an excellent point. Now, women with heart disease, they tend to deny their pain. We know that. There's a lot of things we're learning in the last 10 years about women and how they present to the emergency department. You know, we need to make sure that they get seen. Does anybody have any other questions about this particular patient? Anything they want to say?
No. Her vital signs were normal.
They were. They were.
But still,
her blood pressure, heart rate, everything. She just, as you said, was a little tachypneic.
And I didn't see her pulse ox. What was that?
I believe it was 100%. It was
okay.
Normal.
Because, I thought the shortness of breath was quite evident.
I wanted to give her an emesis basin.
Well, that's
a good point. She had so much epigastric distress. Just watching the video, I was concerned.
Mm-hmm.
And that bothered me a lot, too. But we really tend to blow off women, and even in some of the teaching that we do, we still find a lot of nurses that don't want to take females seriously with this kind of chief complaint. And it's kind of surprising, but still there are people that want to minimize women with epigastric distress, and it's not something that you want to do.
They make it high risk. They're so vague. And
right. They are vague.
We're so vague in how we speak about our complaints. We tell too much.
Mm-hmm. What would she have to look like to make her a level one?
Well, some instability in the vital signs.
Maybe. What if I said her heart rate was 180?
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Then she'd go up.
Yeah, definitely.
If her color looked worse as well, if she had diaphoresis as well as the epigastric distress and the shortness of breath.
Either hypotension or hypertension, either one.
Good. Interesting case. I think we learned a lot from that one.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.